Jay Shrek, myths, legends, and the occasional lie. White lie, though, right? You know, I had a chance to go to the Rogers Cliff Dwellings in the Superstitions, and I've been wanting to do it for a long time, and I finally got it done. I'd had somebody call me and tell me that they had a hot lead on the Lost Dutchman's gold, and it was supposed to be 300 meters basically east of the ruins, I didn't come out successful, but we definitely took a good look. And anytime that there's a possibility of something out in the Superstitions that could be a lead, I jump on it when I can. Now let's talk about the cliff dwellings. Those cliff dwellings are 600 years old, and if you ever wanted to have an Indiana Jones type adventure where you go out and actually get to experience something as close as you possibly can to treasure, because that is absolutely a treasure spot. Now the road going in is hellacious, and the hike going in, because of the trail being kind of covered, a lot of trees down, made it a little more interesting than it would have been. You're going to spend a couple hours getting in. You're going to spend an hour and a half or so getting up the road. So get in there early. But man, when you get there, it is absolutely stepping back in time. It's like somebody turned the clock completely back and you walked into another time. And when you look at the walls of that dwelling, and you remember, I've been into dwellings that didn't look that good, that were national parks, right? And to be able to go up there on your own and to be able to just sit there and feel what it was like to be back in that time, and the fact that those structures are still so well preserved, and hopefully they stay that way. One of the most incredible things I saw was when you see their fingerprints in the mud, you realize that, man, these are real people, right, that were living their life. And one of the most incredible things is when you look at the ceiling and you can still see the thatch that's 600 years old, and the wood that's over the doorways that is 600 years old. How incredible is that? So just to get to experience that, even though we might have swung and missed on the Lost Dutchman gold, it's unbelievable. So if you like this kind of content, please subscribe. It would help us out immensely to be able to allow us to continue to share the history. You know, some people can't get in there. It's not the easiest hike. And if you can, it's an awesome place. But if you can't, hopefully you got to go along with us. Jay Shrek, Miss Legends in the Occasional Lie. And we're heading to the ruins today to see what the ruins are like. The road going up here, and we are in absolute middle of nowhere. The ruins, or the road itself, is unbelievable. Well, so far so good. We've come to the cross between Rogers Canyon and the Rivas Ranch. 109 to 110, we're gonna take 110, and hopefully we'll be there soon. Well, we finally got here, and I tell you what, it wasn't anything like the pictures. I mean, when the pictures I saw, I could have swore it was like the canyon opened up and you looked down, and then all of a sudden you saw, all this, these structures. But I mean, we're here and I do see the structures, but I didn't realize it was gonna be as steep as climb up as it is right through there. But regardless, I made it down here. I'm here with James. That's looking down the valley right there. There's the ruins right there, some of the ruins. So we're in the area where Rivas would have been. The Rivas Ranch is on over. And they said that the Lost Dutchman was in these vicinities. And man, how rural this is. The hike wasn't like super difficult, but it was a lot more, than I thought it was gonna be. And You know, and it was on the way down. You know, on the way back, we're going to have a couple hours going back, but it won't be that bad. But it's a little worse than I thought. So far, nothing has been like I thought it would be. The road getting in here was just horrific. It was terrible. And that took forever. About, what, an hour and 20 minutes? 2 hours. So it took us 2 hours to get in. You know, some people had talked about an hour and 45, and maybe that was before. There's trees all over the trail. The trail's kind of crappy. But there's not a whole lot of places when you get in. Here's what you get to see. Well, we got in here, and this is what we came for, right here. Okay, this is the real deal. This is the real deal. A little sketchy going down the back, a little clifted area. Got a hell of a time getting a grip. Your average bear wouldn't be able to do it, but. Wow. What?
Oh, it goes in that.
Oh, okay, I thought. Tell you what, this is spectacular. This was worth the price of admission. You know, of all the stuff and the 20-mile road. And everything that we went through. And in the Lost Dutchman, they mentioned this location as being the mud home. And this place is spectacular. You know, this would be, wow, a national park. If I don't fall on my ass, so it just goes to show you, but you gotta be careful. There, looking down is what you get. Up the canyon from where we came. This is absolutely spectacular. Man, this thing goes back and back and back. So, here is the... could you get a light on this back here? So this looks back in here. You see this room here? Looks like where they, actually I was going to say their food, but if you see the roof, what you'll notice is that it's blackened, but they had a fire. And you'll see that perch right there, hanging there waiting to knock somebody on the head, right there. So they had this hold off, closed off. I wouldn't doubt if all that was closed off, and they used that to get through. I'll tell you what, this place is absolutely spectacular. You really, you know, you don't see them with the roof still on it. And regrettably, somebody has vandalized that. But wow, how spectacular is that? Unbelievable. This place is truly worth the adventure, definitely. Another fire there. That might have been, that's somebody was here, you know, later. It's not old, even though that might have been. And there might, you know, who's to say they don't have crevices back up in there? It looks like handholds through here, here, and here, here, and then here, and to clip it up, and door right here. Definitely that's carved out right there. Wow, this is pretty unbelievable. You just don't get a chance to see stuff like this out in the middle of nowhere. You know, we are in the middle of nowhere. We're probably about 25 miles into the Superstition right now, is what my best guess is. And man, you just don't get a chance to see stuff like this. Look at this here, still the original beam right here. You know, that beam, somebody put that beam there, you know, 400, 600, 700 years ago. And these walls are still here and they're still pristine. Look at that. That is fabulous. You would get shots even like down lower in here, here. Yeah. Look at that roof. Look at that. Look how they constructed that.